Vince McMahon has made his first WWE appearance since the allegations made against him, and a major AEW star has returned to television. But first, let's get to our first Vince McMahon story, as he has stepped down as the chairman of WWE. Following recent allegations made against him by the friend of a former employee via the Wall Street Journal, WWE chairman and CEO Vince McMahon has relinquished his duties in both roles, with his daughter Stephanie taking the reins on an interim basis. In a statement from WWE Corporate yesterday, the company would confirm that an investigation into the alleged misconduct by its chairman and CEO Vincent Kennedy McMahon and John Laurinaitis, the head of talent relations, was underway, with Vince himself being quoted as saying, "I have pledged my complete cooperation to the investigation by the special committee, and I will do everything possible to support the investigation. I have also pledged to accept the findings and outcome of the investigation, whatever they are." On top of this, a report from Fightful Select notes that John Laurinaitis is expected to leave WWE due to the claims of misconduct. The new interim chairwoman of WWE, Stephanie McMahon, would address her new role and added, "I love this company and am committed to working with the independent directors to strengthen our culture and our company. It is extremely important to me that we have a safe and collaborative workplace. I have committed to doing everything in my power to help the special committee complete its work, including marshalling the cooperation of the entire company to assist in the completion of the investigation and to implement its findings." Stephanie would then take to Twitter for further statement and wrote, "Until the conclusion of the investigation into recent allegations, I am honored to assume the role of interim chairwoman and CEO. I love WWE and all it continues to do to entertain billions around the world." It's worth noting that Vince will retain his position on the creative side of WWE, despite him stepping down from his more senior roles. It's currently unclear on the long-term future of the chairman slash chairwoman position of WWE, and of course it depends on the outcome of the investigation, which there is currently no timeframe for. We'll have more on the Vince McMahon story a little bit later on in the video, but first, let's go to some details of a scrapped Forbidden Door dream match that have been revealed. Earlier this week, AEW star Andrade El Idolo would take to Twitter to reveal that he is unable to work on the Forbidden Door show due to his ties with Lucha Libre AAA Worldwide, with them being a rival of New Japan's partner CMLL. Based on all available evidence, it appears that CMLL and NJPW have agreed to block any AAA stars from working at the Forbidden Door or New Japan shows, so essentially Andrade has a contract with AAA, CMLL have a partnership with New Japan, and CMLL do not want New Japan associated with any AAA talent. Well, we now have some more news on the situation, as Andrade has revealed his planned opponent for the Forbidden Door show before the match was of course scrapped. Appearing in an interview with Lucha Libre Online's Hugo Savinovich, the Idol would state that he was set to face Will Ospreay at the crossover event, with him travelling to Japan to set up the feud. Of course, these plans are no longer going ahead, with Ospreay seemingly set to battle Orange Cassidy instead, with the seeds being planted this past Wednesday on AEW Dynamite. But before we continue, do you want to get your hands on a free copy of Jon Moxley's autobiography Mox? Well, you can do so by using our Audible affiliate link in the description below, which gives you a free trial as well as one free audiobook. As I said, I recommend the Moxley book narrated by the man himself, although there are also audiobooks by the likes of The Young Bucks, Jim Ross, as well as many other wrestling personalities. So be sure to check out our Audible free trial link in the description below, where you can get the Jon Moxley autobiography for free. Next up, Jeff Hardy's state of mind has been revealed following his DUI arrest. Jeff was arrested this past Monday morning in Volusia County, Florida, under charges of DUI and driving with a suspended license, with him now being suspended from AEW pending further investigation. This week, Jeff's brother Matt Hardy appeared on his Extreme Life podcast, where he would address the situation, revealing that his Hardy Boys partner is remorseful and embarrassed, and he would say, "He is just so remorseful, so embarrassed, he like hates himself, and I think that's a part of it too. And he has to know, obviously, what he did was atrocious, terrible, terrible decision making, but then also he has to know that people love him. It's very important, just like you said, at the end of the day, it all comes down to the individual. You have to keep yourself in check, you have to be on top of yourself, and are the only person that can really ensure you're not going to go awry or go in a bad direction, whether it's because of mental issues or whether it's because of addiction issues, as you said. Matt and Jeff were scheduled to appear in this past Wednesday's main event of Dynamite, with them challenging for the AEW World titles against the Young Bucks and then champions Jungle Boy and Luchasaurus. Instead, the match would turn into a 2-on-2 encounter with the Bucks leaving as champions. The Hardys were also scheduled to compete at this weekend's AAA Triple Mania in Tijuana event in a match against Dragon Lee and Ralastico, with Matt now expected to appear with a yet-to-be-confirmed replacement partner. But what do you think the future holds for Matt and Jeff Hardy in All Elite Wrestling? Let me know in the comments down below. Next, we have some further confirmation of a reported WWE release. A few weeks ago, then WWE Women's Tag Team Champions Naomi and Sasha Banks would walk out before an episode of WWE Raw due to creative disagreements, with them now being suspended from the company. In an update provided by Raj Geary of Wrestling Inc. this week, Sasha has now been released from the company, although at the time, no further outlets backed up the report. Well, now two more credible news sources have confirmed the report. Firstly, with WrestleVotes noting on Twitter that they have also heard the same story, and they would tweet, "The word backstage from SmackDown tonight is that the report from the Raj Geary is indeed accurate, according to multiple sources. Sasha Banks has been released from her WWE contract." Sean Ross Sapp of Fightful has also heard that Banks is no longer with WWE, and he tweeted, "Numerous sources at WWE SmackDown believe Sasha Banks has been released, and both sides are just holding off on a statement." WWE has not confirmed the report as of yet, originally reported by the Raj Geary. "I'll keep working for more details or a more solid confirmation." This seemingly means that Sasha Banks' real name Mercedes Varnado is now a free agent, likely with a 90-day non-compete clause in place. She's one of the best female talents in the world today, although it's unclear if she plans to stay in wrestling or continue her acting career following her breakout performance in the Star Wars spin-off The Mandalorian. But what do you think the future holds for Sasha Banks? Let me know in the comments down below. And next up, Vince McMahon opened SmackDown last night following recent accusations made against him. As discussed earlier in the video, McMahon has stepped down from his role of CEO and chairman of WWE, with him retaining his role in creative. With that said, he would use his position to appear on SmackDown last night, his first on-screen appearance since the Wall Street Journal story broke. Vince would enter the arena to a chorus of cheers, with the WWE fans in attendance fully behind him despite the controversy. Whilst he didn't address the allegations directly, he would refer to WWE's motto that is displayed at the start of its shows, and he said, "I'm here to simply remind you about the four words that we just saw in what we like to call the WWE signature. Those four words are then, now, forever, and the most important one, together. Welcome to SmackDown." There has been a report regarding the backstage reaction to the appearance, this coming from Fightful Select, as well as Vince's mood throughout the show. McMahon is said to have been in a good mood backstage and not outwardly reacting to the investigation, and things were described as business as usual before the show. Many were unaware of exactly what Vince would say on the show, with his segment not featured on scripts or on rundowns prior. Fightful sources within the company described the various reactions to the promo, including those of confusion, disappointment, and with even some being enraged. A top talent is said to have reached out to Fightful with a direct quote of saying, "I'm happy it didn't last long, so I didn't have to sit through whatever BS he was going to say." But it shows that he has no accountability, especially when something is directly his fault. Another talent was enraged and hoped Vince handled the situation more seriously, with another calling the response tone-deaf and embarrassing. One source feels that this was Vince's way of putting himself over as a power move to lessen the impact of an investigation's findings. Whether or not the move will work in Vince's favour remains to be seen, but it's clear it hasn't won over some members of the roster and staff, although his future is down to the board of directors. But what do you think the future holds for Vince McMahon? Let me know in the comments down below. And finally, a major AEW star has returned to television. Last night, AEW would air a taped episode of Rampage from this past Wednesday, which saw a big return take place. Darby Allin would take on Bobby Fish, the tag partner of his Double or Nothing opponent Kyle O'Reilly, as their feud continues. After Darby managed to walk away as the winner, Fish would attack his opponent after the bell, before Kyle walked out from the back holding a steel chair. However, before he could get to the ring to strike Allin, the lights went out before the icon Whereupon Sting appeared, blocking his path with a baseball bat in hand, wiping out O'Reilly on the outside. Darby then turned the tide on Fish, locking his leg inside the steel chair, landing on it with a coffin drop from the top rope. This is the first time the Stinger has been seen following the announcement of his injury on the May 25th episode of Dynamite, which ruled him out of the Double or Nothing pay-per-view. The injury is said to have been sustained the week prior when Sting had his leg pinned in a chair by the Undisputed Elite and had it stomped on by Kyle O'Reilly, a spot that was recreated on last night's Dynamite. Now we're likely to see a match between the two teams, although it's yet to be confirmed at this point. And before you go, make sure you check out the 12 most obscure WWE appearances from AEW wrestlers.